हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल मन्हा स्टडी कॉर्नर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लोर चैप्टर वन ऑफ मैथ्स, दैट इज रियल नंबर्स। सो व्हाट आर रियल नंबर्स? रियल नंबर्स आर द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स, इरेशनल नंबर्स एंड इंटीजर्स। व्हाट आर रैशनल नंबर्स? द नंबर्स दैट कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी बाय क्यू, वेयर क्यू इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, आर नोन एज रैशनल नंबर्स। Irrational numbers are root 2, root 3, root 4, so on till infinity. Integers are minus 1, 1, 2, minus 2, so on till infinity. First topic for our discussion is Euclid's division lemma. So what does lemma mean? It is a proven statement used for proving another statement. So I have a real life based application here. We have 7 balls. And we have to take it 3 at a time and arrange them into boxes. One is remaining. How can we represent this scenario using basic division? 3 into 2, that is 6, and 1 is the remainder. 3 is the divisor, 7 is the dividend, 2 is the quotient, and 1 is the remainder. We can also write it out like this. 7 is equals to 3 into 2 plus 1, where dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So I am going to write dividend as A and divisor as B, quotient as Q and remainder as R. This is called the variable based representation. Next is Euclid's division algorithm. What does algorithm mean? It is a series of well-defined steps which gives a procedure for solving a type of problem. How is Euclid's division algorithm different from Euclid's division lemma? Euclid's division algorithm is an application of Euclid's division lemma, and it is used to find HCF, basically of large numbers. You know how to find HCF by prime factorization. That is not what I am going to discuss right now. Right now, I am going to discuss how to find HCF using Euclid's division algorithm and application of Euclid's division lemma. So let us find out HCF of 6 and 60 and 36. Apply division lemma. A is equals to BQ plus R, where into quotient plus remainder. So here we are going to write 60 is equals to 36 into, it goes one time, 24 is the remainder. So 36 becomes the next dividend and 24 becomes the next divisor, and it goes one time and 12 is the remainder. 24 becomes the next dividend, 12 becomes the next divisor, and it goes 2 times, and the remainder is 0. So the HCF is the divisor, which is 12. Let us now find out the HCF of C and D. Step 1. Apply Euclid's lemma to C and D so that we find unique pair of whole numbers Q and R such that C is equals to DQ plus R, 0 less than or equal to R, R less than D. Step 2. Apply Euclid's lemma to D and R. Step 3 is we need to continue the process until the remainder is 0. The divisor at this stage will be the HCF. Let us now look at one more example. Let us find out HCF of 24 and 15. So dividend here is 24, divisor is 15, and it goes 1 time, the remainder is 9. So 15 will become the next dividend here, and 9 will become the next divisor, and it goes once, 6 is the remainder. Then again 9 will become the next dividend, 6 will be becomes the next divisor, it goes once, 3 is the remainder, 6 becomes the next dividend, 3 becomes the next divisor, it goes twice. So HCF here is the divisor in the last step, which is 3. Let us start off with our next topic, that is fundamental theorem of arithmetic. To understand fundamental theorem of arithmetic, there are prerequisites. You should know what are prime numbers and composite numbers, which I am really sure you are well aware of, but still I will take you through prime numbers and composite numbers really fast. So what are prime numbers? Prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7 and so on. So they have exactly 2 factors. And what are composite numbers 4, 6, 8, 9, 10? They have more than 2 factors. So one is neither prime nor composite. So here I am going to show you an interesting pattern. If we multiply prime, we get composite numbers. So 2 into 2, which is 4, 2 into 3, 6, 2 into 2 into 2, 8, 3 into 3, 9, 2 into 5, 10, 2 into 7, which is 14, 3 into 5, which is 15. So here you can see interesting pattern, that is 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 14, 15. If we multiply primes, we are getting composite numbers. So prime numbers are actually building blocks of composite numbers. If you think in reverse order, we can see that composite numbers can be factorized as a product of prime numbers in a unique way, apart from the order. Example, 15 can be written as 3 into 5, and it can also be written as 5 into 3. The order doesn't matter. Another example is 16 can be written as 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. It can also be written as 2 into 3 into 2 into 5. So here's a definition of fundamental theorem of arithmetic. By now you have understood this. Every composite numbers can be factorized as a product of prime numbers in a unique way, apart from the order. I've shown you here examples. 15 is a composite number and it can be factorized as 3 into 5 or 5 into 3. The order doesn't matter here. So let us see the LCF and LCM of 6 and 20 by prime factorization method. So 6, we can write it as 2 into 3, powers are 1. 20 we can write it as 2 square into 5. So what is LCF? It is the product of smallest powers of common prime factor of the number. So here the common numbers are 2 and 2 and the powers are 1 and 2. So the smallest power is 1. LCF will be 2. LCM, just you need to multiply all the remaining numbers, that is 2 into 3 into 5. LCM is the greatest power. So greatest power in 2 and 2, 2 square and 2 is 2 square. So we need to take 2 square, 3 and 5. 2 square into 3 into 5 is 16. So we can get an interesting result here, that is HCF into LCM of two numbers is equals to product of two numbers. That is HCF of A and B into LCM of A and B, A comma B, is equals to A into B itself.